So we will see today a very important part of P block element, and it is group 14 children. And so group 14 is called as carbon family, because carbon is the first member in the family and carbon dominates over the entire group. Carbon is the first member of this family and carbon dominates over this group, and that's why the name indicates carbon family. And so children, this happens in all the groups, all the 18 groups. There is a specific term, like in a group 1, it's called as alkyl metal family. Group 2, it is called as alkaline earth metal family, you know. So similarly, this group 14, group 13, it is called as boron family. Similarly, group 15, it is called as this phosphorus family. Similarly, 16, it is called as sulfur family, oxygen family. Group 17, it is called as halogens, you know, you must be in group 17, halogens. And group 18, it is called as noble gas family. So children, I wanted to tell you that all the different groups, they have this different names, and the names are due to some point that there is the condition, and we see like this. Now coming to this, the members are carbon, silicon, carbon, silicon, germanium, tin and lead. This is carbon, this is silicon, this is germanium, this is tin, this is lead. Now children, SN, it is called tin in English. SN stands for stannum, basically. SN, it is stannum. In Greek, it is SN. But in English, it is tin. And so this is a very important part on this term. So this is the basic introduction of the group. Now children, just we have to go some of the general features of this group. So general features, its physical state. So children, all the elements are solids. You all must know carbon, silicon, germanium, tin and lead. All are solids with different specific features. The features are different. Like, you know, carbon is, you know, inert. Carbon remains as it is and it do not react at the normal condition. Similarly, silicon is similar to it, and silicon is basically in crystalline and amorphous form. Silicon is also stable. It has some non-metallic character also. Carbon has also non-metallic character. Then germanium is similar to silicon. Then tin and lead, they are pure metal children. If you see, so carbon, silicon, germanium, tin and lead. So these are pure metals, and they have more non-metallic character. Because see children, in this group there is the difference in the feature, difference in the properties. There is difference in the properties, and we can have this condition. Carbon, if we hammer, then it will break down, it will split into small pieces. It is brittle. Same is the case with silicon. Same is the case with germanium. They are brittle. They are brittle. That is, on hammering, they break down into small pieces, and so they are, you know, they are having more non-metallic character. And as a general trend, on moving from top to bottom, the metallic character increases. The metallic character increases down the group. Metallic character increases down the group. There is the increase in the metallic character. And you know, tin is metal, malleable, ductile, so on and so on. Lead, it is also there. So this is the very important part about the physical state, physical appearances, etc. So children, just I am going to explain about the electronic configuration or valence electronic configuration. So children, see here, I have written this carbon, atomic number is 6. This is electronic configuration, 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. This is first SL, this is LSL. Similarly, in case of silicon, atomic number is 14, 1s2, 2s2, here it is 2p6, 3s2, 3p2. Now children, what is the similarity? What is similarity in between the two electronic configurations? So see here, 2s2, 2p2. Similarly, here it is 3s2 and 3p2. So 2s2, 3s2, 2p2, 3p2. So on generalized note, what we say? The valence shell electronic configuration is NS2 and NP2. So this is very important part. They have valence shell electronic configuration NS2, NP2. And so the metals, they have the progression. This is one point. But when we move down the group, moving down the group, the electrons enters into d and f orbitals. D and f orbitals, children, d and f orbitals. Now heavier elements, you know, are like lead, like tin. They are heavier, they have much more number of electrons, so it is there, and there is the progression of electrons. The electrons progresses to form the this transition character. The character is displayed which is in the transition state. Now children, the third point is ionization enthalpy. Now, as you know, ionization enthalpy, the amount of energy required to convert isolated neutral gaseous atom into an ion. So the amount of energy required. So as you know, trend, you have read in class 10th also, in this previous group 13 also, on moving down the group, the atomic size increases. On moving down the group, atomic size increases, and so what will happen, children? The metallic character increases. As you know, in the bottom there is tin, there is lead, and you know, tin and lead, they are pure metal. Tin and lead, they are pure metal, so increase the metallic character. And why the atomic size increases? Because with the successive elements from top to bottom, there is addition of a new cell from top to bottom, and so the size increases. So when the size increases, so what happens? The electrons are loosely bonded. So atomic size increases. As a result, electrons in the valence, electrons in the valence cell, electrons in the valence cell are poorly bonded. Electrons in the valence cell are poorly bonded.
So often the electrons are poorly bonded. So what will happen?
Thus, the electrons can be lost or removed by little energy. So there is a requirement of little energy. So what will happen?
On moving down the group, the ionization enthalpy decreases.
So this is the summary. So the ionization enthalpy decreases,
and you know carbon is quite stable. Carbon is quite stable. All are stable, but this is the point about the
ionization enthalpy. And you know ionization enthalpy, it is measured again in kilojoule per mole. So just children, there can be some variation in also. There can be some variation in
every group. There can be some variation because of the internal point of the concerned element. Like
silicon, I am taking this intentionally. Children, silicon and germanium,
they are having the non-metallic character, and you all must be knowing that silicon and germanium, they are the backbone of the electronic industry. Solar photovoltaic cells, all the electronic equipments like ICs, transistors, diodes, they are made from the silicon and germanium. Why? Because they lose the electrons in a circuit. You all must be knowing that all the electronic equipments, mobile, TV, laptop, computer, solar photovoltaic cells, all are made up of specific components like solar cells.
Solar cells, solar plates, or solar photovoltaic cells, they are made up of silicon.
They are made up of silicon. And when the light falls on the surface of solar cell having the silicon, the electrons are lost and the electrons will flow in the circuit. Same is the case with this germanium children. So germanium and silicon, they are best suited elements to prepare the electronic components because they require less amount of energy. And you all must be having calculators at your home. Nowadays the calculators are coming with a dual power supply and they have a small strip of germanium which requires ordinary light. So you can imagine children, the silicon chips, silicon solar plate which is used in the solar photovoltaic cells or in the equipment, so it can lose electrons in a circuit. So electrons flow in a circuit, and so there is the condition. So children, this is very important point about the general feature. So this is about the physical feature. So atomic size, you can take atomic size increases on moving from top to bottom, ionic size increases. So these are some of the points of the this group 14. So children, now we will see the chemical properties. So in the chemical properties children, first we will see the oxidation state. So you know oxidation state, it is the valency exhibited by an element is called the oxidation state. So as it is group 14, so this plus 4 and plus 2, they are the most important. Plus 4 and plus 2, these are the most important oxidation states exhibited by the members of group 14. Now, there is very important point that on moving from top to bottom, the higher oxidation state becomes less stable and lower oxidation state becomes more stable. And so this is due to the what we call inert pair effect. I have explained it. Inert pair effect. So inert pair effect. So inert pair effect prevails. So this again I am writing carbon, silicon, germanium, tin and lead. So children, carbon, silicon, germanium, they have tendency to exhibit the plus 4. But here tin and lead, they have this tin. Tin exhibits plus 4 and plus 2. Lead exhibits, you know, plus 2. Here lead exhibits. This is the most common. This is the most common for the lead. So it is there. Lead rarely exhibits oxidation state of plus 4 in any stable compound. So the compounds of lead in plus 4, they are unstable, and this is due to inert pair effect. And what we say, how we define the inability of the valence electrons, the reluctance of the valence electrons to participate in the formation of bond. So valence electrons, let's take the case of silicon. So silicon 14, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2 and 3p2. So this is the first, this is second, this is third. Now when these two and these two, both the electrons, they participate. Both the electrons participate in the bond formation. So it will exhibit plus 4. So in these three, it will be the participation of all this. But here in case of tin and lead, these S electrons, the S electrons, they do not participate. They are reluctant. They are not willing to take part in the chemical reaction. So as a result, they have this tendency to this plus 2. And so this is very important part to note. Now children, I am going to explain very important part, reaction with oxygen. So the members of this family react with oxygen to form the oxide. So on heating, members of this family forms corresponding oxides. Corresponding oxides are formed, like, you know, CO and CO2. Carbon forms two oxides. Carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide. Similarly, children, this silicon, it forms SiO2. Only. Similarly, germanium, GeO2. They never form the monoxide. You know, there are different conditions, and so the oxides of silicon. Silicon forms one oxide in this condition. So oxide of silicon, SiO, it is stable only at very high temperature. Thus we do not consider stable, or you must say it is formed stable or exhibits only at very high temperature. It is stable, we can see, at only high temperature. So this is the only viable or only possible oxide. Now children, we'll see about the properties of oxides. So in all the family children, there is the difference of a lot in the character of the oxide. Some oxides, you know, they are acidic, some oxides are amphoteric, some oxides are basic. Line group, in group 13, you have seen the earlier members are, you know, acidic. Lower members, in case of aluminium, they are amphoteric, and lower are basic in nature. So similarly also, here there is formation of CO2, there is one oxide, it is CO2, then SiO2, GO2. There is the formation of these oxides, and these oxides, they are acidic in nature, they are having acidic character. These are acidic. Now, the other oxides, as we go down the group, like tin oxide, PbO2, SnO2, they are not, this acidic, and they are amphoteric. So this difference is due to, children, the ability to dissolve in water to form the acid or base. So they respond reactions with bases. They react with acids and bases both. So one very important point, children, I would like to say here, that in case of this CO2 and this all, the lower members, they are not water soluble. Only the oxide of CO2. CO2, when it is dissolved into water, there is formation of this carbonic acid. It is carbonic acid. And other oxides like, children, silicon, germanium, tin and lead, they are not water soluble. So this is the only soluble compound. Other oxides are not water soluble. So this is very important to note. Actually, children, the solubility depends on the ability to attract the water molecules, and so other members are there bigger. Just I am giving the, you know, in nutshell, other members are bigger in size, so they cannot attract the water molecules, and as a result, they are not, you know, able to be dissolved. Now, children, one more point about this one, the dioxides. Now, coming to about the monoxides, that CO, carbon monoxide, is neutral. It is neither acidic, it is nor basic. Now this germanium oxide, it is having the acidic character, and so tin oxide and lead oxide are amphoteric. Tin oxide, SnO and PbO. Children, they are amphoteric. So there is no variation in the character. In the previous group, the train was different. They were acidic, here amphoteric and here basic. But here, in group 14, it is reverse, neutral. So this is very much important to understand some of the basic points.